Hey, what's up guys? Nuno here. D5 Render just released its latest version, and in this video, I want to walk you through some of its best features. First up, we have the new GI. The latest release of D5 Render version 2.4 brings with it a number of significant improvements, but perhaps the most noteworthy is the upgraded Global Illumination. In 2.4, the new GI algorithm enhances the lighting in poorly lit scenes by increasing the GI bounces of the skylight. This change has a profound impact on the final result, as demonstrated in a side-by-side comparison with the previous version 2.3. As you can see in the comparison, the 2.4 version fills the space with light much more effectively, resulting in lighter shadows and a more evenly lit scene. This eliminates the need to rely on additional lighting sources, such as area lights by the windows, to fill the space with light.
And another thing to note on the 2.3 version is that when you move the camera, you see a lot of this noise. You see a lot of this noise happening here. So, of course, in the final render, this will not be seen, but you do have to wait a little bit so to see how the end result will look. Now, opening the same exact scene in the D5 render 2.4, you can see a huge improvement. You don't see, when you move the camera, you don't see that big noise anymore. So everything is much cleaner, okay? And even the lighting, you can already tell a big difference comparing one and another. I'm using exactly the same settings. I just opened the same scene in 2.4 and we can see already a big improvement. I'm going to show you a side-by-side comparison of this exact render without any texture, so we can compare just the lighting. So as you can see with the new version, we don't have such dark shadows and we have a more balanced scene. And we don't have the need anymore to use those area lights by the window, even though we could use them. But now this new GI avoids having to use this type of lighting all the time.
The upgraded GI feature in D5 Render 2.4 makes it easier than ever to achieve realistic and immersive 3D visualizations. And second feature is subsurface scattering material. To witness the subsurface scattering effect in action, all you need is a smartphone flashlight. Simply point your flashlight at your fingers like this from a close distance, and you can observe how the edges take on a reddish hue. See how I pass my phone? This is a visual representation of how subsurface scattering works by simulating the way light penetrates and scatters within translucent materials, resulting in a more soft, diffuse glow that enhances the appearance of an object. This is a lighting technique used in 3D computer graphics and animation to create more realistic materials such as skin, wax, and marble. Let's take a closer look at an example to better understand the impact of subsurface scattering material. In the image, we have a character that is rendered without the use of subsurface scattering material. The surface of the skin appears flat and lacks depth, making it look artificial and unrealistic. However, once we add the subsurface scattering material, you can see a significant improvement in the final result. The soft reddish glow that appears where the light penetrates the skin gives the character a more realistic and natural appearance. The subtle shadows and highlights add depth and texture to the skin, making it look more like a real human skin. And next feature is new edge assets. D5 Render has added more options for the edge assets in its latest version. The most significant improvement, in my opinion, is the ability to quickly and easily create edges or green walls by selecting all the assets that are named single. To create edges using this feature, simply select the desired assets and set the brush tool radius to maximum. Then click on the surface you want to cover with the edges and boom, the selected assets will automatically fill the surface. This makes the process of creating edges or green walls a lot quicker and more efficient. Quite nice, isn't it? And guess what? I'm excited to share that I'll be hosting a workshop for D5 Render 2.4 where you can learn how to create an amazing interior scene. If you are interested, you can sign up for the waitlist using the link in the description below. Don't miss this chance to level up your rendering skills. Next feature is more frame rate options for video rendering. In version 2.4 of D5 Render, the video rendering feature now offers more frame rate options for users to choose from. These options include 24, 25, 30, 60, and 120 frames per second. Each of these frame rates serves a different purpose and can be used to achieve different effects in your videos. For example, 20 frames per second is typically used in movies because it creates a distinct look, especially in fast-moving scenes where you see a lot of motion blur. On the other hand, 60 or 120 frames per second can be used to create a slow motion effect. It is worth noting that by default, only 30 and 60 frames per second options are available. If you want to unlock the other frame rate options, you need to go to the menu, select Preferences, and turn on the frame rate on the widget. This will enable you to access all the available frame rate options and create videos with a frame rate that best suits your needs. Next up is Improved Material Emissive Effect. There is a significant improvement to the emissive material's light intensity. The update allows ZDAF Render to calculate multiple bounces of emissive lights in the global illumination, resulting in a more accurate preview and output results. With the latest version, emissive material's color will be more detailed based on their texture maps. It is important to note that the lighting effect will be different from the previous version, the version 2.3, due to the more accurate calculation of the light bounces. Next, we have camera focal length. This is great news. ZDAF Render now has a camera focal length feature. With this new feature, you can adjust the camera focal length to follow the equivalent real-world lens physical parameters, which makes it easier to select the best shot for your scene. To access this feature, simply go to the top right corner of the screen and click on Camera. From there, you can adjust the focal length by dragging the slider or typing in a specific focal length number that you would like to use. This new camera focal length feature will allow you to choose the perfect focal length for your scene and create more accurate and aesthetically pleasing renderings. The next feature is ZDAF Channel. ZDAF Render now includes the ability to render a ZDAF channel. The ZDAF render element is a useful tool for adding depth of field to your final image in post-production using a compositing application, without having to re-render your entire scene. It can also be used to create basic fog effects. To access this feature, go to Effect, Style, and turn on the ZDAF mode. From there, you can adjust the white and black points by dragging the slider to control the depth of field effect. Objects that are closer to the camera will be colored darker, while objects that are further away will be colored white. These two points will affect the color of the ZDAF channel output in your final image and video rendering. With this new feature, you will have more flexibility and control over your final output, making your post-production process much easier and more efficient. Next one is Path Tool Improvements. The Path Tool in ZDAF Render 2.4 has some new features. You can now choose between Curve and Linear modes. Curve mode is the same as before, where you use a Bezier curve to create the path. But with Linear mode, you can adjust the smoothness of each point individually. Additionally, there are changes to the Path Tool for Vegetation Assets. You can now set a fixed distance between plants in meters, and ZDAF Render will generate the right number of assets based on that distance. Next feature is Backdrop Planes. This new version comes with 9 different backdrop planes, which are pre-made images that can be used as a background for your 3D scenes. These backdrop images are useful in hiding the horizon line, which can make your scene look more realistic. To add these backdrop planes, go to Landscapes tab, and then select the Outdoor Components category. Next one is Color Temperature for Interior Parallax. You can now change the color of the light inside your interior scenes more easily with a new temperature parameter. This allows you to adjust the color temperature for each interior parallax individually. To use this feature, simply select the interior you want to edit and look for the temperature parameter. By moving the slider to the left, you can make the light warmer, and to the right, you can make it cooler. This can help you achieve the exact look and feel you are going for in your interior scenes. Next one is new assets. ZDAF Render has added various new assets that you can use in your scenes. These include edges, new plants, dynamic Asian characters, subsurface scattering materials and models, transportation assets, and dynamic water particles. The dynamic water particles are particularly interesting, and you can find them under the particle category in the fluid section. You can customize the look of the water particles by adjusting parameters such as reflection, scale, and color. There are even more cool features in this new version of D5 Render. Check out the link in the description to see the full list of updates. Let me know which feature you like the most, and make sure to sign up for the Interior Workshop waitlist. Alright, I'll catch you guys in the next one.